Hello. Let's take a look at some of the key new features that have been added to mWater over the past year. In this video, we'll cover the following 8 topics, and you can find more information in the video notes. All of these updates also apply to our sister platform Solstice, which goes beyond wash, whereas mWater focuses on water, sanitation, hygiene, and health. We'll take a look at asset management features, the new languages that have been added, the new navbar and what it makes more prominent and available, some new question types in the platform, as well as the new way to import survey designs from spreadsheets and XLS form. We'll take a look at the training center and how it can help you structure learning about the platform, as well as data visualization updates in the form of brand new vector maps from some months ago, as well as a set of data visualization updates. So let's go. The big release from 2022 is undoubtedly asset management and asset system features in mWater. Basically, these allow you to track and manage water system assets down to the level of individual taps, meters, pumps, and valves, all kinds of parts that you might want to track in a water system. So we're going beyond just individual water point sites, boreholes and such like, and this is an implementation of mWater's asset management standard, which means that there are standard properties for each of these different asset types, which make it easy to collect key information. Those fields are already defined and they're right there. So you can just pick up the free functionality and start mapping your water utility assets. Recently, we also released this asset survey question, which allow you to connect surveys and assets. And that way you can then define any questions and collect any data you want by designing a survey and linking it to your asset. So you might have a monthly pump survey or a meter survey or a survey that covers the entire water system. Here on the right side, we just see an example dashboard showcasing some of the features. And the big vision here, of course, is that this is a very flexible system that should be able to cover all kinds of use cases, from individual boreholes where you want some other assets to be tracked, such as tanks, power supplies, pipes, treatment units, then all the way up to rural water supply systems with maybe a mainline pipe and a number of connections. But there's really no limit. It can go all the way up to large urban utilities in terms of mapping those assets and getting something digital in there, which will then allow you to understand what's there and to plan ahead. So take a look at the documentation we have and learn more about asset systems and see if that's applicable to your work. Now in 2023, we released the new navbar, a visual refresh to the mWater portal, where we reorganized navigation with dropdowns, making navigation faster. A couple of things that might pop out from here that I just want to mention. We put sites front and center, sites and assets, in the first dropdown because they are such a key feature of mWater and are now even more prominent. So if you are doing any kind of infrastructure mapping with mWater, that's not to do with assets, entire water systems with their assets, then consider using sites. These are great for mapping a place once, optionally making it visible for others, and then doing updates to it over time using linked surveys. The idea, the big vision here, is that organizations can do the best they can with their own work, and gradually the broader picture of what's happening in a county or a region or a country will become better and better established. You'll also notice that there's a new tables link available in the manage dropdown. These are an easy way to bring in data from any other source. So you can come there with a spreadsheet, upload information, and then visualize it or analyze it alongside the data that you're collecting as sites, assets, or surveys. So if you've got data that you really need to see side by side and it doesn't fit a survey, and doesn't fit a site, give tables a try. Here we see an example. We've added some new languages to the mWater and Solstice apps, so that the app is now available in 24 languages, including German, Italian, Japanese, Javanese, Luganda, and Sundanese, in Indonesia. Now, this is the translation of the app, which means that all the interface in the app will be available in this language if you choose it. However, I want to remind everybody that you can design your surveys in any language at all and translate them to multiple languages. That translation is up to you and it can be done through the portal. Speaking of survey design, there are a few new question types to mention. So we have now asset questions, which allow you to pick an asset system and link your survey to one or more types of assets, tied to the earlier point. We also have ranked questions, which allow you to define a set of options and then ask the enumerator to order them in an order of preference. So give those a go if they are relevant. Following on with survey design, we now make it very easy to bring existing survey designs into mWater and Solstice, either through simple Excel spreadsheets, where you've defined the headers, or XLS forms, which is a standard defined format with the option to include additional things like question options and conditionality. So that makes it easy to design your surveys also offline, or if you're switching from places like ODK, Kobo Toolbox, or other platforms which are able to export their survey designs into spreadsheets or XLS forms, then you can bring them in quickly into mWater as well. Of course, wherever relevant, you can use the online what you see is what you get drag and drop editor to design your surveys. If you're teaching mWater or learning it for the first time, consider visiting our training center at training.mwater.co. This is where we have some structured courses that help bring users up to speed both on the portal and the surveyor, especially if they don't have much exposure to it before. In our resource center, we have plenty of overall guidance on different topics, but if you want a methodical way to go from the basics to more advanced use, you can enroll to these courses for free, view the materials, and also complete quizzes. And if you've completed them all for a module, you get a certificate at the end. So take a look at the training center. Moving on to data visualization updates here at the end, you will have seen an update on the portal to vector maps, a big update behind the scenes. They make our maps faster, meaning we can render hundreds of thousands of sites as the scale of use of mWater keeps growing. The vector maps are drawn instead of rendered from tiles, so it allows us to give more granular zooming options and zooming levels. And you can rotate the map with your mouse if you hold the right key, right click down, and then just rotate the map. Can make for some impressive visualizations in certain cases, but it's faster, more scalable, and more zoomable. Continuing with Dataviz updates, we have a whole bunch. For example, tables with frozen headers, meaning the headers will always show. You can set color rules to color certain cells, and you can also show totals, such as the sum in a standard table widget, or the average, or whatever. We have new kinds of expressions, such as concatenation, when you want to combine many calculations or texts into one field. We also have assorted updates like pop-out labels for charts, the ability to filter out blanks from pivots and charts, all based on a new charting library called billboard.js, which brings a number of small updates to how charts look and feel, but also allow us to start building other question types or chart types if needed. So if there's something in mWater that you would really like to see as new functionality, get in touch and we'll discuss. Everything can be built if it fits in our joint plans. And hopefully you've enjoyed these updates. I will add the links to more information in the video notes, and wish everybody a great day ahead.